Welcome back to the Midnight Who Show, and today we're going to be reviewing another live-action DC Comics movie. Of course, Birds of Prey and the Fabulous Emancipation of One Harley Quinn, or I think they actually just changed it to Harley Quinn, Birds of Prey. I still think with that one, they should have still added and Harley Quinn and the Birds of Prey. And actually, that is one of the biggest negatives I had with this film. One of the criticisms of this movie is I don't think it should be called Birds of Prey. It is a Birds of Prey film toward the very end, at least when I was watching. It's like, okay, you're kind of setting up all these characters and then they team up at the end. To me, it's like, this is the origin stories. This is the origin story of Birds of Prey. But really, this felt like Harley Quinn's movie. It was narrated by Harley Quinn. She was the main focus of this movie. This was Harley Quinn's story. And the Birds of Prey were kind of the supporting characters who were along for the story. I think that's actually a better title, is it's Harley Quinn and the Birds of Prey. Because honestly, when they start teaming up and become the Birds of Prey, they're really good. Let's talk about the characters in this movie. Of course, the main Birds of Prey, and of course, the villains. Now, of course, Margot Robbie's Harley Quinn is phenomenal. I enjoyed every single moment she was on screen. She definitely is Harley Quinn. I think she does a great job with her performances. And of course, she has the humor, which I really enjoy. And some of the most hilarious scenes are in this movie. Probably my favorite is with this egg breakfast sandwich. I still think about whenever I think about this movie right now, is it's just hilarious how she just wants it so bad. But now she has all these people chasing after her, of course, because you know she broke up with the Joker. So a lot of people are going after her now. And I really just enjoy how she's trying to hold on to that. And finally, Renee Montoya just kind of stopped her. Yeah, and she's like, no, my sandwich. She did get it at the end, which I thought was great kind of callback. I really love that scene. Still my favorite part of this movie, and honestly, it's Harley Quinn's movie. So, of course, she narrated the movie, as I said, and at the beginning is a really kind of cool opening sequence, which is all animated, kind of shows a little bit more about her backstory, and is, in a way, I guess, cleverly trying to not say that they didn't get Jared Leto back as the Joker in certain parts because they just animated it. But yeah, Renee Montoya and Huntress, I would say, are the weaker, and to a lesser extent, Cassandra Cain, I would say, but mostly these two, because they just don't have much development to me when I was watching it. It's like, Renee Montoya, cop, is really wanting to get this case built against Roman, and of course, Huntress is known mostly as the crossbow killer, and we don't really see much about her until the very end, when it was like, okay, this is actually a pretty decent character. They did a pretty good job. Actress did a really good job with the performance on Huntress, and that's the biggest positive I will say about that. But honestly, out of all the Birds of Prey that got the most development was, of course, Black Canary. I really enjoyed Black Canary in this movie. Her performance was really good, and she was definitely a highlight of this movie. And Cassandra Cain is more used as like this middle character. She's kind of the hindrance for all this because, of course, she stole the diamond and there's kind of this people going after her and Harley kind of has to protect her. So these kind of that type of character. Roman, aka Black Mask, was a great villain. I really enjoyed him as a villain. He was a great Batman villain brought to the screen. And I think the actor did a great job in his performance of this character. I will also say this movie has some really good action scenes. I definitely enjoyed the one in the jail cells. And of course, the prison kind of evidence room, that was a great fight. And of course, the fight toward the end of the movie was great. All these fights were pretty well choreographed, which is really good. And of course, the directing of this movie was phenomenal. It was just a great time at the movies. Of course, there is violence, there is language. It definitely kind of lives up to the R-rated, but I think it was still worth it. The problem I have with this movie is a little bit sometimes it is a little jarring when Harley Quinn kind of narrates, she goes back to another scene that we saw earlier or kind of all that. So that can get kind of a little bit crazy sometimes, but it doesn't take away from the movie. I will say the story of this movie is a little on the weak side just because it's just a bunch of fight scenes, action, you know, humor, but it was still an okay story. I will definitely give it that. But honestly, what I'll remember most about this movie is just the entertainment. Overall, it was a pretty decent film. I would definitely give it a B. But tell me your guys' thoughts on this movie in the comments below, and I'll of course see you guys in the next video. Bye, everyone.